lately I find you're on my mind more than you know.
He's usually open and he's usually in, and there's usually a fire lit, and there's always a cup of tea on offer. And interesting conversation to be had.
I knew Terry already, but I went around to see Terry and I needed work, and he immediately gave me a job. He said, I'll get down here tomorrow morning and get cracking. And really, I followed a year of the most creative work I've actually got into, with Terry right behind you all the time, you know, pushing you. What, haven't you finished that yet? No, get on the case. No, he wouldn't have you talking with anybody else or anything else. You could have a cup of tea and a joint, and, but you had to keep you had to keep working. And he got the most wonderful stuff out of us. And it was like a dual thing with Terry, because he wanted the work, but at the same time he always wanted to develop the person, mostly young men. But he does have the most savage and awful temper.
I've always seen Terry Gray as being a role model, mostly for young men, but also a keeper of lost boys, a bit like Wendy in Peter Pan. There are also a few lost girls and other people, but mainly I see him as being a father figure for a lot of men who I've seen over the years have maybe fallen out quite severely and have always come back. Terry Gray is one of the rudest people I have ever met in my life. And I have actually spent a lot of time in his company and travelled with him, and he has shivered my timbers right to the very, you know, the very foundations of my being.
Well, I don't know. Some people say good old Schrader and others tell the truth. I feel I've done a service to the community, because I think a place like this is sustainable in any small town. I don't know why other people don't do it. You know, it's low key. It's no big deal. You know, you're not making a lot of money, but it keeps a lot of people occupied who would otherwise be sort of sitting in the park drinking paraffin or whatever they do. What we do, we recycle timber from old buildings, mostly second fixing timber, such as architrave, skirting boards, doors, flooring, and then sometimes pieces of furniture that have been mishandled, broken. We convert it and rearrange it into something that's serviceable. And we use all the old mouldings and the stuff that we reclaim from the buildings to give it an effect of, say, a Victorian or a Georgian piece. And what about you, Princess? Would you like some tea? What about an alcohol pop? I've got one left over from the last party. So what goes on in Islington then?
Well, most days it's...
You know Tony Blair, do you?
No.
You live near him?
No.
You must do if you live in Islington, that's where he lives.
Well,
there's a big park there, isn't there?
Yeah. No, I don't know Tony Blair.
Get in here. Don't let those blokes see you. See that? Look. I couldn't do it without these bricks. Each one of these bricks has got GWR stamped on them. It's like, you put one of these, God, central heating. I've got two in the bed, one went on your feet, and they stay alive. That one was been in there 3 hours, it's still warm. This is Ganesh. I'm making a poo jar for him, for the tsunami victims along the Coromandel coast.
When Shiver Me Timbers is to be closed down, it'll be a great loss to the community. New things will come in and replace the old, but it's that link with the old world and that quality of life that, and feel-good factor, you know, that's not the rushing pace of everything that's trying to achieve something and be big out there in the world. It's the opposite direction.
Hot bricks, roast chestnuts, fresh Ganesh. Wet wood and shivered timber.
Oh, he's a great dancer. You've never seen anybody dance like Terry. He reminds me of Ganesh. Dancing Ganesh.
Back to dear old freedom.